Welcome to this session on how to debug in JMeter. In this session, we are going to see how do you debug and fix errors in your test plan and how can we use Debug Sampler in JMeter. Towards the end of this session, we will also look at some useful tips. So let's get started and let us see how can you debug and fix errors in your test plan. Let us go to our JMeter and let me just create a very simple test. So I'm going to a test plan, add thread users and thread group, and now inside that thread group I'm going to add sampler and I'm adding a simple HTTP request. So let me go to the website lifecharger.org and I will copy this URL and give it here. So I do not need this part. And that's it. So we are going to do a very simple test on this website. Let me add a listener and I am adding view results tree. And if I'll run it now, let us also save it. So we get a successful request and here are the results. So the very first step, in case you are finding any issues in any of your test script or test plan, you should always add this view results tree listener. Now this listener is a memory consuming listener, so you should always disable it when you want to run your actual performance test, but it is very useful and handy while you are creating your test. So in this listener, you can go here and you have the options to go look at the sample result, the request, and then you have this option to look at the HTTP format or the raw format, and then response data, which gives you all the data. And you can do any search here as well. And in your view results tree listener, you have this drop down. So if you go here, you can see there are all these reg exp tester, xpath tester, HTML, and other options. So when you are creating your test plan which has all these different elements, it will be very easy and useful. And then the second thing that you can do while you want to debug your test is go to the top of your JMeter window and you can see this icon here. This is the log viewer. So if you click this log viewer, you will get the logs at the bottom. So you can see all the logs are here. So in case there is any issue or problem with your test, you can get the information here. For example, you are using some external file and the file is not available, or there is some issue with the properties, you will find all the logs available here. So this is how you can very quickly debug your problems in your test plan. Now the second thing is we can use a debug sampler which is available in JMeter. So let me go back to my JMeter and I will go to my thread group, do a right click, add sampler, and here you will see debug sampler. Let us select this and let us understand this debug sampler. Debug sampler is a very simple and straightforward sampler that gives you information about your properties and variables used in your test plan at runtime. So you can see we have these three options: JMeter properties, variables, and system properties. You can make it as true or false, whatever you want to view in the logs. And then the other important thing is you should always have the listener view results tree, because debug sampler results are only viewed inside this listener. So let us run our test again and let us see the results now. And you can see we have got the result for our actual request, but we also have got the result for debug sampler. And here inside debug sampler, you can see we have the sampler result, the request, and the response data. And in the response data, you have got JMeter variables, JMeter properties, and then the system properties. So this will be very useful in case you are using any variables or you want to know the properties used during your test. Let us see an example. I'm going to my test plan and I will just add some user defined variables. I am saying a is equals 1. And I will add another variable b and another variable c. So I am adding these three variables. I have not given any value for b. And let us now go back and look at the results. I am running it again and go to Debug Sampler, and now you can see the JMeter variables are listed out here. So you can see and troubleshoot any of your variables. In case you are using any external files like CSV files, all the information about those variables will also be listed down here. So it will be very useful, very handy and very convenient. And do not forget to disable this listener when you are doing your actual test. So you can do a right click and disable this listener before starting your actual performance test. Let us look at some useful tips. So in case you want to add a debugger only to a particular element or request in your test plan, you can use a debug post processor. So for example, I will go to my HTTP request and I will go to add post processor, and you can see here we have debug post processor. So debug post processor has all those things that we had in debug sampler. The difference is the debug sampler you cannot add inside a request or as a child of a particular request. It will be added as a thread group element and it will show you all the results of all the requests. So in case you want to debug any particular request, you can use debug post processor. Also, you can enable debug for elements. For example, in my HTTP request, I am going to add a config element HTTP cache manager. And now what you can do is you can select this element and go to the top, go to help and enable debug. So what will happen is when you enable debug for some particular element, in the logs there will be some extra information shown. So when you run this, you will see in the logs there will be some extra information which will come only after enabling debug. So this will again help you in debugging your test. And then you can also use some external plugins. So until now, all the features that we have seen for debugging will be very useful in most of your cases. But however, in case you are creating a very complex test plan in JMeter, having a lot of scripts and other elements, and you want a really high level of debugging features, what you can do is you can go to options and plugin manager. In case you are not getting this option, you can watch the earlier tutorial on how to get plugin manager in JMeter. And once you get the plugin manager, you will get this window with these three tabs: installed, available and upgrades. So all the available plugins that are there for you are listed out here. The plugins which are already installed are listed out here. So you can find plugins like BlazeMeter step-by-step debugger. So this can enable debugging, like you debug your code doing stepovers and doing a step-by-step debugging. So if you get this plugin, then you will get this option for debugging step-by-step. This is the icon for step-by-step debugger. Also, you can get this under run menu and step-by-step debugger. So this is something that you might require in case you want to do a high level of step-by-step debugging. I hope you are now well equipped to debug your test plans and samples in JMeter. In case you have any doubts or queries, please do write them down and I will try to respond as soon as I can. Thanks for watching and keep learning.